I don't really think there's a law against these things. It's just disrespect of the law, or disrespect of the flag.
Well, yeah, okay, so if that flag belongs to a World War II veteran, that's vandalism, that's property damage, and probably several other things, and so there should be, a person should be arrested and prosecuted.
Oh, for the one like up in Oceanside and stuff like, oh, yeah, definitely, and that, they were looking for the, you know, because it was a case of vandalism.
They caused personal damage to that person.
Mike, I think there was an additional comment back there.
Gentlemen, back.
Yes, sir. That's an interesting question regarding the flag. I remember when I was in patrol, retired, I arrested a guy for stealing a flag off a veteran's flagpole in Lemon Grove and taking and putting his headliner in his van, and I caught him with the headliner. And actually, it turned out that he was charged with a military veteran's code violation. Plus, of course, grant that, all the other charges. But there is a military and veterans code defacing the flag.
All right, okay, good, thank you. Okay, my time's up. One final question?
It's a loaded question.
Okay.
I was thinking that when we go through the juror process, you're right, we get asked, can you judge this just based on the, on the comparison of the facts of the law? And so I'm surprised because of the incongruity in what we're learning here and that hasn't gone to the Supreme Court. I'm surprised.
Well, yeah, and I've been involved in the law as a layperson many cases over 30 years. And what surprises me more than anything is that lawyers don't understand. If any of you are horse people, you understand if I say I want to buy a stallion from you and you deliver a guilty, then I didn't get what I paid for. And, the gelding, for those that don't understand, can't see the mayor. So, there's no benefit in that. It's the same thing with a jury. What is a jury? It's an organization, usually of 12 men or women, that have the charge of judging the facts of the case as well as the law. And that's in the Webster's 1812 dictionary. That is the definition of jury as it's put in the Constitution, and I don't care, no legislator and no judge can alter that definition, and when they say you can't do that, they're giving you a gilding, not a stallion. And justice doesn't bear fruit. Yes, sir.
As a practical matter, though, we have things like the civil rights issue. We have the Jim Crow laws, which, as you say, ought to be local because it ought to be local.
Right.
And yet they were all white juries judging a black man, and just because he was black, he was thrown in.
Right.
And so you have these kinds of conflicts. Now, the Constitution itself is a national thing, and then you have the conflict with the state. So you got that sort of thing. That's the Constitution. And then the state, the Constitution, the national interest of one man, everybody prevail.
Right. Yeah, when there's injustice at a lower level in government, I'm not going to say that maybe that doesn't, the federal government stepping in is not constitutional, but, if they break the rules here and there, don't make it a rule to break the rule. But if they break the rule for purpose is senior to policy, really, and to make sure everybody's got freedom. If they break the rule once in a while for that, okay. But generally, the rule of the Constitution needs to hold. And so there was probably other ways to solve that issue, but they went to the federal government. The other way would be citizens to stand up and say, no, you're not going to do this kind of thing anymore. And that's what we have to do as citizens. One person get on that jury, one white decent human being get on the jury and say not guilty, and then a better way to suffer. And they have a lot of dollars.
Okay. Thank you.